Nicole here. Today we are going to talk about this beautiful, probably not so beautiful right now, Begonia Maculata Wightii. Recently, a lot of you sent me messages on Instagram or Facebook and said you found this plant in your local Home Depot, Walmart, or Lowe's. I'm so happy for you because in Kansas City area, I couldn't find it. So please, Custer Farms, send some shipments to Kansas City. I really need a Raven ZZ plant. Anyways, if you got this plant, and I am going to share some care tips with you because definitely this plant is not growing well, but it was worse before. So my parents got me this plant in summer 2019. It was so beautiful. I really love the pattern. Like one side is green and white polka dot, and on the back side is the pure red or a little bit pinkish and maroon color. I really love it. It grows so fast, so well for me last summer. However, when it entered into the winter months, it was not doing great. I mean, it's still not doing great. So especially the bottom leaves got a lot of crispy edges, and I actually pulled a few leaves out already. See? So this leaf, half leaf already turned crispy, and the color supposed to like green and white, but already faded to like lighter pink and a little bit yellow color. Basically all the bottom leaves look like this. It looks so bad. And this one is the bigger leaves. The green already fade out. Yeah, it just looks so terrible. I didn't know what to do, so I figured probably one, the low temperature in my house, because I usually keep my house around 60 to 62 degrees Fahrenheit, which is about 15 degrees Celsius. And in the evening, it's even lower, 58. So yeah, one is temperature, the second one might be the humidity. And I found the humidity actually impacted the most. You probably know that I don't have a humidifier in my plant room because I like easy plants. I don't like any plants that are finicky or require so much from me. I just don't have that much time to take care of them, you know. I love you. I love you so much. Anyways, I decided to take it to the shower room with me every night. Yes, I shower in the evening. It got better. The new leaf actually got no crispy edges. But once I stopped doing it for a few days, it started the crispy edges again. So this one is bad, but if I keep taking it to the shower room, it will stay the same. But if I don't, the crispy edges area would get larger and larger and larger. It will look like this, and then eventually it will look like this. It makes the whole leaf damaged. It's bad. So if you got this plant at home, please make sure you can provide the high humidity to this type of begonia. I have another begonia plant. That one is doing well. It's doing very well, actually. That, let me show you. This is the begonia angel wing. It's so pretty. No crispy or yellow leaves. Yeah, it looks so healthy and the leaves are so big. But compare this one and this one. Can you tell how sad this one is? I'm so sorry. Even though they're from the same family, but you have to admit, one kid requires less from you, but the other kid requires more from you. So if you get this one, make sure high humidity and warmer temperature would be great. I'm looking forward to spring or even summer so that I can propagate this. You can see how laggy this one goes. Super laggy. So I probably will cut right here and then put it in the soil and propagate. But I learned from this lessons next year, once it enters into the fall season, the autumn, I will take you to the shower with me every single day, okay? Alright, that's it for today's video. If you have this Begonia Maculata Wightii, make sure you provide high humidity. Temperature higher, the better. Alright, I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye.